In this video, we will configure the PI UFL interface. Since I've already installed the interface, the first thing we'll do is register our interface with PI Interface Configuration Utility, or PI ICU. Let's start by opening PI ICU. We need to make sure that we're able to connect to the PI server that we're going to send data to. Go to Interface, SDK Connections. Make sure that your PI server is listed here and that you can connect. If your PI server is not listed, you can add it by right-clicking and selecting Add Server. Now that we know we can connect to our PI server, let's load our interface. Go to Interface, New Windows Interface Instance from EXE. Select Browse and navigate to your PI UFL directory. This is the directory where you installed the UFL interface. It should be located in the PI PC Interfaces folder. In the PI UFL directory, select the piufl.exe file. Then, select your PI server from the drop-down menu. Now we need to configure a point source for our interface. The point source tells the interface which points from the PI server to load. The UFL interface is unique because it can write to any point on the PI server. We still want it to load the points that it knows it's going to write to, so we'll define the point source as UFL. Then select Add to load the interface. We've now created a new interface instance. Let's start configuring. Go to the UFL tab on the left side of PI ICU. The first thing we'll do is create an ini file. The ini file tells the interface where to get the data, what the data looks like, and then what to do with the data. We now need to tell the interface how often to look for data files. Switch to the General tab in PI ICU. We can tell the interface how often to look for new data files by creating a scan class. We'll create a scan class by clicking the New Scan Class button in the Scan Classes section. I'm creating a scan class with a scan frequency of 30 seconds. Let's click Save to save our changes. We've now finished the configuration of our UFL interface. So let's create the interface service. Switch to the Service tab in PI ICU. In the Service tab, click the Create button. The interface service is now created and ready to run. However, we don't have any tags created on the PI server yet, and we need to make sure that the interface is allowed to write data to the PI server. Let's switch to the PI server to create that configuration.